Hi guys, welcome back to Taste with Twist. In today's video, we are going to make tasty and healthy whole wheat flour banana bread. But before that, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already and ring the bell icon to get notified whenever I post a new video. To make the banana bread, in a bowl, here I have 3/4 cup of wheat flour. To that, I'm adding 1/4 cup of corn flour, a pinch of baking soda, 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Give this a good mix and keep this aside. If you want to skip corn flour in this recipe, use 1 cup of wheat flour. Into another bowl, take 2 ripe bananas and mash them well with a fork. The riper the bananas are, the better your banana bread will taste. After mashing the bananas well, keep this aside. In the meantime, preheat your oven at 170 degrees Celsius for 10 minutes. Take a large bowl and add 1/4 cup of softened unsalted butter and 1/2 cup of brown sugar. Beat the butter and sugar well with a whisk or electric hand mixer. We won't be using any refined oil or refined sugar in this recipe. Brown sugar is much better compared to refined sugar as it has naturally occurring minerals in it. Continue beating the butter and brown sugar until it turns light, fluffy and pale. Now add in 1 teaspoon of vanilla essence. Crack a large egg into the butter mixture. Make sure that the egg is at room temperature as the egg will whip very well if it is at room temperature rather than when it is cold or directly out of the refrigerator. Mix well with a whisk until the egg and butter mixture is well combined. After that, add in 1/2 portion of mashed bananas and mix with a whisk until well combined. We are simply alternating between the flour and mashed bananas. After the mashed bananas are mixed well, add in 1/2 portion of the flour mix and mix well with the whisk. Only after the flour is completely mixed into the batter, add in the remaining portion of the mashed bananas and continue mixing well. I'm not adding any milk in this batter. I'm keeping the batter thicker than usual. If you are using this method, the crumb will be a little drier, and if you don't want that, add 1 or 2 teaspoons of milk to this batter. After mixing the mashed bananas well into the batter, add in the remaining flour and mix this well. As I've said, I'm not adding any milk in this batter. I'll show you the crumb texture of the bread that I've baked with milk and without milk so that you can decide for yourself which one you like better. I personally prefer the one without milk. The banana bread batter is ready now. I have added 1/4 cup of semi-sweet chocolate chips. This is totally optional, but I recommend adding the chocolate chips as it will take the banana bread taste to a next level. If you don't have chocolate chips, chopped nuts will also go very well with this bread. Now grease a medium-sized loaf pan well with butter or oil and line it with a parchment paper. Transfer the banana bread batter into the prepared loaf pan. As I have not used any milk in this batter will be on the thicker side, so you'll have to manually spread the batter with a spoon or spatula and make a gash in the center of the loaf. This is simply to help the loaf rise while it's baking. Bake this banana bread at 170 degrees Celsius in a preheated oven for 30 to 40 minutes or until the toothpick inserted in the center comes out almost clean. After 30 minutes, check every 5 minutes if the bread is baked. Now, this looks ready. Keep this on a wire rack for 10 minutes to let it cool down. As we have already greased the pan well, the loaf will come out of the pan very easily. After taking the loaf out of the pan, let it cool down for 10 more minutes on the wire rack. The smell of freshly baked banana bread is very, very delicious and very tempting. I like to slice this bread and have it when it is still warm. So this is the texture that we get when we don't add any milk to the banana bread batter. The smell and taste of this bread is very delicious and it is reasonably easy to make. This is the bread that I've baked adding 2 teaspoons of milk to the batter. The bread is much softer and moist if you add milk. Do try this tasty recipe and let me know how it goes for you in the comments. As always, thanks for watching. Until next time, bye!